here's the cinnamon bell.
Now, if you'll all put on your thinking caps, you'll remember that Judy and Jimmy and the Cinnamon Bear were captured by pirates last time. But these pirates were very different. They didn't make people walk the plank, and they didn't hunt for gold. All they wanted was candy, and plenty of it. Captain Taffy offered to sail them as far as the island of Obi, where the pelican had dropped their silver star. And what do you think? When they got close enough, they sighted a roly-poly policeman on the beach wearing their star on his chest. Right now, the Susie Q is about to drop anchor, and the children will have their star back in a few minutes. That is, if nothing happens.
All right, hearty. Bosun, pipe the anchor.
Aye, aye, sir.
Well, my friend, it's been a pleasure to have your company aboard the good ship Susie Q.
Gee, we sure had lots of fun, Captain Taffy.
That's what I say, too. I never knew pirates could be so nice. Did you, Cinnamon Bear?
Bless my stuffings, no. And we're much obliged to you, Captain.
Don't mention it, matey.
I sure would like to know what that roly-poly policeman is doing with our silver star on his chest.
Well, we'll know pretty soon, Judy, because Captain Taffy's going to give us a boat so we can row ashore.
I'm sorry the candy pirates can't go ashore with you, but confidentially, we're on our way to capture a big hoard of yummy marshmallows. Mmm, I can taste them now.
Sounds most enticing. But marshmallows always get stuck in me fur.
Well, what's this island like, Captain Taffy?
Well, it's a very strange place. Most magical, in fact. Very large and inhabited by all manner of strange people and things.
Gee, I hope we get a chance to see a few things. Are you pirates coming right back?
Just as soon as we capture those yummy marshmallows. Won't take long, and you can give us a signal and we'll take you aboard again. But in case you need to leave the island in a hurry, you'll have the rowboat.
We're sure awful grateful for everything you've done for us, Captain.
Not at all. The pleasure's been on our side. Are you ready?
Ready and raring to go, Captain.
Very well. Bosun, pipe the boat.
Go ahead.
Hey, you better let me help you in. There you are, young lady.
Gee, this is going to be fun.
All snug as a bug in a rug, eh? Lower away.
Goodbye, Captain Taffy.
Goodbye. Thanks a million.
Yeah, much obliged indeed.
Cast off the line. Goodbye, mateys, and good luck.
You take one oar, Cinnamon Bear, and I'll take the other.
Barnaby Bright, strike up a bit of our chanting.
All right, Cinnamon Bear, let's roll.
Weren't they lovely pirates? And Captain Taffy was just wonderful.
A gentleman, I says, a real seafaring gentleman.
Oh, Jimmy, I can see the policeman ever so close now.
Swell. I can't see because I've got my back to him. Are we heading in the right direction?
Sure we are. I can see, Jimmy, and don't worry about it. I got complete control of the boat, haven't I?
We're almost to the beach, Jimmy. You're at him.
All right. Wait till I turn around a little. Hey, policeman!
I guess he doesn't hear you.
Let me do the yelling. It takes a big voice like mine to do the trick. Hello, officer! Officer!
And what do you want?
What are you doing with our silver star?
What?
I'll handle him. Hey, you! What are you doing with that silver star?
Sure, and I'm wearing it. What do you suppose I'd be doing with it?
Yeah, but you got no right to wear it.
Oh, haven't I now? And by golly, who has more right to wear a star than a policeman?
But it's our star.
You bet, and we're coming right in there to get it. Come on, Jimmy. Just one more pull on the oars will scoot us right up on the beach.
What's the matter here? We're stuck.
We don't move an inch, and neither does this wave that the boat is on.
Try again.
It's no use, folks. That's a magic wave. It'll tape anyone from landing in a boat.
What do you mean, a magic wave?
Just that, magic. That particular wave never rolls in. Just stays where it is all the time. You can jump down if you like.
Oh, but it's too far. Most 5 times as high as us.
Or dive in and swim under it.
Oh, never. My precious stuffings.
And in either case, your boat will drift out into the ocean.
Grr.
And you lose it.
Grr. Am I mad? Just wait till I get my paws on you, Flatfoot.
That's an insult, to be sure. I'm a roly-poly policeman, and roly-polies don't have feet to be flat.
But what are you doing with our silver star?
Yours, is it? And what would it be doing dropping out of the sky?
Penelope, the pelican dropped it. She stole it from us.
Sure, I didn't know that at all.
What do you do, Mr. Fleeceman? Just stand there all the time?
Not at all, son. I patrol.
Oh, lollipops, how can you patrol without feet?
Oh, with a roll this way and a roll that way, I can patrol about 3 feet on either side of me. Not much, maybe, but it's patrolling I am, and I am law around here.
Fuddlesticks, you're nothing but
Stop
an old...
Stop being so mean, Cinnamon Bear. That's no way to get our star back.
I should say not. Mr. Policeman.
Yes, ma'am. What can I be doing for you?
Well, you might let us have our silver star. It's been stolen or lost ever so many times, and we've just got to get it back. It belongs on the tip-top of our Christmas tree.
Sure, and it's sorry I am to hear that. Being meant for Christmas myself, I know how it is. If you'll just come ashore, I'll give it back, sure enough.
Will you? I'm a stingin'. Gee, that's swell. But gee willigers, what about this magic wave? We can't get ashore.
Well, I'd toss it up, but I'm afraid I'd miss. You'll have to row down the ways. They tell me that this magic wave doesn't go more than 100 yards or so.
We'll be back right quick, Mr. Policeman, and thanks ever so much.
Glad to be of service, ma'am.
Now, see how nice he is when you're polite, Cinnamon Bear?
Soft soap. That's all soft soap.
Shame on you.
Oh, let's not fight. Grab your oar, Cinnamon, and we'll get going.
Sure made that in a hurry, didn't we? Do you think the boat will be safe there, Cinnamon Bear?
Sure. I fixed it, didn't I?
Come on, let's hurry and get back to the policeman.
We'll hurry as fast as we can, Jimmy. The sand is awful hard to walk fast in.
Yeah, my cinnamon paws sink down in it.
You know what? I was just thinking about the crazy quilt dragon. I wonder what happened to him.
I wonder. Too bad the pirates didn't take him on board. He sure turned out to be a good guy, saving us from those bad Inca boos and everything.
Huh. Maybe you think Crazy Quilt's a better friend than I am, huh?
Oh, no, Cinnamon Bear. You're a really, truly friend.
Do you think so?
Look, we've almost reached the policeman.
He's got his back to us. Hey, Mr. Policeman!
Louder, Judy.
Just a second till I get my breath. Yoo-hoo! Mr. Policeman!
He's turning around.
Jimmy, look!
He hasn't got the silver star on.
Mr. Policeman, where's our star?
Well, I guess your friend didn't find you yet.
What friend?
Well, the one I gave your star to.
What do you mean? Did someone say you were to give it to him?
He did that, and very polite he was, too.
My goodness, who could that be?
He swam through the magic wave shortly after you started down the beach. First, I wasn't going to give it to him, the star to him, but he told me you were coming right back for it. But he said he knew all about it.
What?
And that you told him to pick it up.
Jiminy Crickets, who was it?
Faith, I don't know his name, but he was a dragon and looked a lot like a crazy quilt.
Garrah, am I ferocious? That crazy quilt dragon, up to his old tricks again.
Oh, dear, whatever will we do?
Well, first off, I'm going to push this fat-headed policeman in the tummy.
Oh, don't, Cinnamon Bear.
I got to. It's a point of honor. Watch out, Flatfoot. Here I come. I'll push you flat on your back. That's what. There. And let that be the lesson.
Willikers! The policeman popped right back up again and knocked Cinnamon Bear out.
That's what happens to feisty fellows who forget to remember that when you push over a roly-poly, he comes right back up. Kowowie.
Poor Cinnamon.
Call me early, Mother dear. Call me early.
Shake him, Jimmy. He's coming, too.
Wake up, Cinnamon Bear.
Oh, my poor stuffing. Where's that policeman? I'd tear him limb from limb.
Now, just be quiet. You've had enough.
Which way did the crazy quill dragon go, Mr. Policeman?
Well, I didn't watch him careful-like, not being quick to turn around. But I think he headed straight up the beach that way. Funny, too. Just happened to think, now, that'd be the wrong direction if he wanted to catch up with you. Faith, and I bet he was running away.
Huh. Why, you
are... Stop it, Cinnamon Bear. You've got no time to fight.
Come on. We'll have to go like the very dickens to catch up with Crazy Quilt.
All right, but I'd sure like to take another poke at that celluloid so-and-so. I'd shock him.
Hurry, Cinnamon Bear, hurry.
Gee, I can't see a thing ahead of us. Nothing but sand and sand and sand.
Well, seeing as how you wouldn't let me show you how to finish that pesky policeman, I'll show you how to catch Crazy Quilt. Come on, I'll lead the way.
Look at him go, Jimmy.
I'll say, I never saw
Jimmy, Jimmy, what's happened to him?
Gee, I don't know. He was running right there ahead of us, and then all of a sudden...
He just disappeared.
Well, what's all this? Everything looks just right for a merry chase after the Crazy Quilt Dragon and the Silver Star, and then Cinnamon Bear ups and vanishes into thin air. It seems that Judy and Jimmy just jump from one difficulty to another. I'll certainly be with you next time to see what made Cinnamon Bear disappear all of a sudden like.